Your son, your friends that you prioritize over the dhikr of Allah, the gossip, that gathering that you attended, is it going to stay with you for one night in that grave? Only one night, not the whole time, one night. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إرغاما لمن جحد به وكفر، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم خاتم الأنبياء المعتبر. صلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي وعلى آله أهل الفقه والنظر والعلم والأثر، وعلى من بآثاره مكتفى واعتبر. There is a hadith that Imam Suyuti narrates. It has some weakness, but Imam Suyuti made it حسن. The clip that has حسن. And the hadith says this. It's a dua. And it's a dua that we all should learn. And the dua says, Allahumma rzuqna hubbak. Oh Allah, give us the rizq of your love. Rizq. Not everybody has this rizq. You might have the money. You might have the power. But the love of Allah, you might not have. Allahumma rzuqna hubbak. Look at the hadith. Hubbak wa hubba abdin or wa hubba man yanfa'una hubbahu indak. This is the narration. And the love. Oh Allah, give us the rizq of your love so we can love you. And give us the rizq of loving something that is beneficial to you, for us with you. What does that mean? يعني you love العلماء. You love الأولياء. You love الأنبياء. You love the good deeds. You love these things. These things, the love of these things will help you actually, because the love of these things is the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the love of Allah jalla jalaluhu. The love of the Anbiya is the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The love of the Sahaba is the love of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The love of Ahlul Bayt is the love of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These kinds of things, that their love will help you, will be beneficial for you. Yanfa'uka, will be beneficial. What will make you beneficial in the day of judgment? In your qabr, your good deed. When you raised your son and your daughter, you raised them because you love them for the sake of God, for the sake of Allah. When you love them for that sake, not for your own sake, for the sake of Allah, and you raise them that way, then you will take that deed with you as cash in your qabr and in the day of judgment. You will, when you love the ulama and you love the anbiya, you love the anbiya and the awliya and the good deeds, you will take that love as something that's beneficial for you. Be careful where you love. Someone might say, Shaykh, you're making it very difficult, so I can't love my family and I only have to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How about I love both of them? ما جعل الله لرجل من قلبين في جوفه. Allah says, Allah did not give people two hearts. Gave you only one heart. Gave you only one heart. But you love your family and you love everyone else as an obligation for the sake of Allah, for the sake of God. And I give you this example of a Sayyidah Zainab. I'll make it very quick. When she asked her, when Sayyidina Ali was asking her, maybe he gave you that example before, but it's okay. When she asked him, she was 5 years old, and she says, Oh Father, Sayyidina Ali is her father, Oh Father, do you love us? He says, Yes, I love you. She says, How can you love us and love Allah in the same heart? He says, Then what? He's teaching her the freedom of speech, not he's asking her because he doesn't know. Because sometimes we may be tyrants in our own homes. Sometimes we don't give our families the rights and the freedom Islam gives them. Huh? He says, then what? What do you want me to do? She says, how about you love Allah and you take care of us? Understandings. The signs, the three signs real quickly of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that you have no waswas. The waswas stops. Because what? فَبِعِزَّتِكَ لَأُغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ By your izzah. The shaitan is saying, he's swearing, Oh Allah, by your izzah, by your majesty, I will misguide them all, إِلَّا عِبَادَكَ مِنْهُمْ الْمُخْلَصِينَ Except your sincere slaves. Those, I have no way to get to. Those I have no way to get to. Realizing that the shaitan is not ghafil on you. That should make you realize, you should realize the shaitan is not sleeping. So when you realize that the shaitan is not sleeping on you, realize also that you, that someone also is observing you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the 10 days of Ramadan, last 10 days coming. It's an opportunity. Let's make them an environment of the love of Allah and His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let's make our homes buzzing in the salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The whole day, the whole night. Give them tasbih or masbaha or subha. Give them whatever you want. Have them do it with their fingers. Make your family busy in these days and nights with the salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Make your home everyone saying different salah, different this. One doing tasbih, one doing tahleel. Energize your home, revive your home, resuscitate your home, and that will resuscitate your heart. I'll finish with this event, Al-Hajjaj, the tyrant, the big tyrant that you all know. Al-Hajjaj, fasiq to most and kafir to some. The Sahaba declared in kufr, as the Imam Ibn Hajar narrates. Anyway, one time ashab, yani he went out to the desert with his people, his soldiers. So they put him in the middle of the day, desert, very hot. Says, give me, put the food. They put the food, they put the water. He says, stop anyone who's coming in the desert, stop him and have him eat with me. I don't want to eat alone. And I don't want to eat with, he doesn't want to eat with his soldiers, so he wants. So they found a Bedouin walking in the middle of the desert, and he's wrapped up. As you see people who live, who are in the desert, even though it's very hot, but they wrap themselves up with thick clothing. That's something, again, some other time we'll talk about that. They brought him, the soldiers brought him, he says, you have to sit, and you have an invitation from the Amir. So the Hajjaj told him, why don't you sit? Halumma la ta'am ya Arabi, come to the food. He says, no, thank you. He says, why? He says, because someone who's more generous than you has invited me and I already accepted. He says, who is that? He says, Allah invited me to fast and I'm fasting today. He says, you're fasting and today is a very hot day? He says, yeah, I'm fasting a hot day for a day that's much hotter than this day. Coming. He says, but the food is really good today. It's very tasty. So fast today, break your fast today, and then fast tomorrow, break it today, fast tomorrow. He says, will you give me a guarantee that I will live till tomorrow? He says, I cannot do that. He says, then how can you ask me to do something that's not in your hands? He says, but the food is very good. He says, the food is not good because of your cook or because of the food. He said, then why is the food good? He said, the food is good because Allah gave you health and afia so you can taste it. The rest of the story some other time. It tells us, seize the opportunity. These are the opportunities of barakat, the opportunities of rahmat, the opportunities of forgiveness, the opportunities of illumination and enlightenment in the next 10 days. Please change your home, change your nights, change your schedule at nights, change your schedule during the work. Take whatever you need so you can count so many tasbih, so many istighfar, so many la ilaha illallah, so many salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Make your tongue very busy in the salat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam can come and be realized in your mind and in yourself and in your heart and in your soul. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala Ali Muhammad. Kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala Ibrahim. Barak ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala Ali Sayyidina Muhammad. Kama barakta ala Sayyidina Ibrahim wa ala Sayyidina Ibrahim. Fil alameena innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma nsuri l-Islam wa al-Muslimin. A'liya maulana kalimata al-haqq wa al-deen. اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه إليه، من أراد بهم غير ذلك فاجعل دائرة السوء عليه. اللهم رد المسلمين إلى دينك ردا جميلا. اللهم ارزقنا حبك وحب من يحبك وحب كل عمل يقربنا إلى حبك وحب كل شخص يقربنا إلى حبك. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله صلاة ترضيك وترضيه وترضى بها عنا يا رب العالمين. اغفر اللهم لنا ولآبائنا ولمشايخنا ولمن له حق علينا ولمن على الخير أعاننا وعن الشر أبعدنا ولمن أوصانا بالدعاء. وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وآله. أقم الصلاة.